Next on Jonathan Bird's Blue World, Jonathan learns how to take a census of marine life and count fish.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Bird, and welcome to my world. Wonder how many fish are in the sea? Well, biologists have, and today I'm in Rockport, Massachusetts for a special event to answer that very question.
And that event is the Great Annual Fish Count, coordinated by the Reef Environmental Education Foundation. The fish count takes place worldwide, and I'll be diving along with many other divers in Massachusetts to identify and count fish. Why count fish? So biologists can learn about trends in fish populations to better understand and protect those populations. For my part of this project, I'm diving on Cape Ann in Massachusetts. Other divers are spread out all over the USA and the world. But before my day of fish counting, I stop in at Bob Michelson's fish identification course. Bob is the regional director of the Great Annual Fish Count.
So we're going to start with our top 20 species, the most sighted frequency of each fish. First one on the list is the cunner.
Now you would think that since I've been diving in New England for over 20 years, I would know all the names of the fish. But it turns out a refresher is never a bad idea.
You'll see over 100 of these fish on a given survey while you're diving.
The morning of the big day, each diver checks in with a reef volunteer and gets a sheet to fill out with the day's finds. And it's always a good idea to listen to the dive briefing, especially when you're diving a new site. Finally, it's time to go count some fish.
So I can write down what I see.
My slate works underwater, so I can make notes as I go. I'm heading into the water with a bunch of other divers. We'll spread out to cover a large area. Hopefully, we don't all count the same fish. As I head out to deeper water, first I cross a vast expanse of sandy seafloor. There isn't much here, just a bunch of drifting seaweed and a few rocks. Finally, I get to the bigger boulders out a little further. There's kelp and plenty of good places for fish to hide. This should be a good place to find some fish. I'm not taking any chances. Maybe I'll sneak up on the fish. At last, a fish! I found a cunner. I'm not that proud of myself, though. The cunner is probably the most common fish in Massachusetts. So I keep swimming with my eyes peeled, and then, aha! Finally, some luck, a sea robin. This curious little fish walks along the bottom on finger-like pectoral fin spines, and it's not very common on Cape Ann. My dive buddy Mia makes a note. That's a great find. Heading out a little deeper, Mia and I finally hit pay dirt, a huge school of pollock. Now all we have to do is count them. One, two, three. Hey, stop moving, you guys. Oh well, I'll have to just guess and write down, I don't know, 100. That sounds good. Heading back towards shore through the kelp-covered rocks, we eventually return to the sandy shallows and decide to take a look around. I find a strange pair of eyes in the sand. It's a flounder, perfectly evolved for this habitat. A little coaxing reveals the whole fish. Thank you. Nearby, another creature of the sand, a skate. This relative of the stingray has no stinger for defense. It swims along the bottom by pushing off with its pelvic fins and then gliding a foot or so just an inch above the bottom. I'm finding some good stuff out here on the sand, but as I turn to head back to shore, I find something quite rare. It's an Atlantic torpedo ray. This ray has no stinging spine either, but it can defend itself by delivering an electric shock of up to 220 volts. I'm definitely writing this one down, even if nobody believes me. I keep a safe distance as the ray decides to swim off into the depths. Any animal that catches its prey by electrocuting it deserves some respect. I head back to shore with a nice cross-section of fish sightings to show for the dive.
Well, that was great. We found a lot of fish, some cunner, a really big flounder, some skates, and a huge school pollock.
So now I need to get dried off and go report our dive results. We go to Stage Fort Park, also on Cape Ann, where the reef representatives have set up base camp. To make the counts scientifically valuable, I have to fill out a form listing everything I saw and how many. I can't wait to write down the part about the torpedo ray. Bob is looking pretty busy running the event, but I get a quick tour.
Tell me what everybody's doing here.
This is Citizen Scientists at its best.
It's a great event. How many people we got?
Don't have the final totals yet. There's still people out counting fish and surveying, but I'm expecting to end up with 90 to 95 divers today. It'll be the 11th consecutive year we've held the largest fish counting event in the United States here in Gloucester.
So I finished my dives here in Rockport, counting fish, along with thousands of other divers all over the world that were counting fish today as well. And what's really cool is to think that all this data collected will be helping scientists decide which species of fish are in decline and need more help, and which species are doing just fine.